It's a Saturday.
Rather be at home. But instead I'm here. Got the machine, is at 270 already. Got power disconnected. Gonna put an alternate rod through the gears of the ring spring in. Pressure off of the rake shaft. Alright. Hop back around. Our rig board off. Need some pliers. Move the edge washers. And I think they've subbed out a bolt on one of those. I don't know what time it is. Take a wild guess. No intermediate step here. Just a big step down. 3/4? Yeah, all right. It'll work. Pin to replace this bolt. You don't want to put a bolt back in here.
Poor form.
Pins are also in backwards. The X washer should base the kickback, not the pin. Some missing bushings. Got a lot wrong here. We got more wrong than we got right. But that's how it is sometimes. Gem nuts are already loose. Rods out instead of tucking them to the side. Okay. And again, it might be a waste of time. I'm not sure. Watch the clock. I don't really care how long it takes. I'm more concerned that it is getting done properly. Like those J-bolts the other day. That was fun. PTSD from that already. Alright, spring's coming on. We'll live there for a minute. Yeah, I'm not sure that Ray Hook Link going back in is brutally worn out. Bolt out. Top bolt coming out. Excuse me. It's quiet in here. Oddly, too quiet. Give it a left hand kind of reach around thing here. Alright, so we're gonna lift inboard side over the spacer. Left hand is holding a tiny spacer. You don't want to lose that little thing, because most of the time, there's not a spare. If there is, you are one of the luckiest people in the world. Don't have enough room. Don't have the room. Can't drop the belt crank out because there's not enough room between the curved shoe and the frame. But we can make room if we remove this X-pin from the moving deck, or not moving deck, hook selector. There you go. Knocked out. Ta-da! Magic! Combined with a little bit of gravity. Oh yeah. That is bad. Going to the garbage. Alright. Great drop spring one. Great drop spring two. That cushion lift sounds wonderful. Covered in a bucket of oil. They don't have any other maintenance repair technicians. They have a couple of guys that chase calls and do what they can. Yeah, let's just it's done. This side's done. Where are we at? We need to take the pin out on our rake spring tube, drop our turret supports, and then unbolt from the frame. Oh, it's so tight. It's such a tight area. Used to be really quick at this pin, but thank you. too much thread sticking out. I can't go down. Oh, can we go up? Can we go up? Set it on the frame right there. Cool. Oh, these are 11/16. Which I did the frame. They have that mounted decently, and sometimes it's wrong, and it's very difficult. All right. That one's off. Thing to keep in mind, drop the turret, jab B. If this slams down, it can crush. No, nope. But this one will crush the turret and micro switch. We don't have any room, and we're not going to force the turret down. When you force it down there, you're forcing it up in the back. That's a good way to kill that switch. So we'll just go ahead and move it real quick. Should be 5/16 or 11/32. It's so dark in here, I can't see shit. But I got two flashlights here for extra light. I only have two flashlights, plus my little pocket flashlight. All right. Turret jam micro switch is off. Zero chance of crushing it now. Everything. These are 9/16. Sometimes they're Allen bolts, sometimes they're
soon.
Oh, boy. Yeah. That one was very tight. All right, let's do this side.
Come right with me.
Yeah. Take them all the way out again. Okay. I get for complaining about it being a little spooky quiet in here. Now we have music. YouTube doesn't like music. Well, keep changing the station like that. It won't flag anything because it won't be cutting off. Alright. No shims on this side. Pull both bolts out. Let that side hang on the front of the sea lever. See? Tricky, tricky tricks. We have two shims in here. Yep. Pull those out. Set them right there and save it. Alright. Supporting the weight of the rig shaft with my left hand, taking the bolt out with the right hand. Pull that forward. Take our pivot out. And then the whole thing come down. Rest in the gutter for right now. Okay. Other pivot out. We don't have enough overhead clearance, so we're going to bring the rake arms into the pit, in between the deck light and the deck. We're going to go out under the masking unit. You stay there, I'll be right back with the new one. Same thing in reverse order. Pivot's gonna go in there. Again on this side. I make them vertical. They're not quite vertical on the frame, but it's a good place to start. Problem. two ships. One looks like a 50,000th and the other one looks like a 30,000th. That's not a quarter inch. And I don't think they have any more ships. Well, I guess we're going to send it. Some wear marks in here that are lined back up almost exactly where this was before. Maybe a little higher in the front. A lot of guys tend to droop the front of the turret down for some reason. I don't know what the logic is. I bet it's to keep that full deck latch from unlatching during a strike. Drop the front of the turret, that latch lifts away from the roller on the deck shaft. So instead of fixing the problem, droop the front of the turret, cover it up. Not the best way to do it. Okay, let's bring our shot back around. We're not going to put that rake hook back on. We
probably have to either rebuild it or find some new ones. Turn the camera off, but that's swapping a rake shaft. There you go.